Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Siege of Dragonspear, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We are now prepared to bed down for a while and get some much-needed rest. Saved it for this episode, a separate episode, just in case something happens when we try to do that. And let's find out. Resting. Is that me, or did the little resting cinematic thing look more pixely than normal? Anyway, we rested for a day and 16 hours, including healing spells, because, well, all we have for healing is Minsk, and I'm guessing myself, my special, you know,
what?
Power of a Cure Light Wound, so that's why, yeah, we really need a proper cleric.
Aye.
Minsk agrees.
Less talk, more fight! Yes!
So now we're down... we have to go through here first, right?
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Come on, gather.
Yes!
Yes! So I guess we're just going to leave.
Let's talk more fight!
Clear a path, she says. I can't even pick us out. Where's our friend? Corwin. She says, wherever we're going, let's get there fast. There's a fine line between a crowd and a mob, but I'd rather not be outside when it gets crossed. You have no sense of adventure. I had a sense of adventure once, then I had some adventures. Now I just have sense. Where are we going? What do we have for options? You tell me. We're to acquire equipment and allies for the trip north. There's a couple of Reshemi adventurers we can talk to at the three old kegs, that bard, or the thieves at the Elf Song Tavern, or a monk at the Iron Throne building. Or we could just return to the palace. We went to all those places, didn't we? Yeah. Reshemi adventurers are in our party. And the three old kegs. The bard, we did not pick up. The thief, well, we have one of them. The other one wouldn't come. And the monk would not come. Wherever we're gonna go, let's go. All right, so... exit. The exit. Alright. What is the way out of the city? Or can I get more of a... So wait, we're here. Yeah, I want to leave the city. I'm pretty sure it's not through the palace. And the Flaming Fist T-Ax is there. He would not join. Hold on, let me see if there's anything. Maybe I have to... trying to pick out these quests from, you know, the quests going on from the quests from the main game. And we're all mixed in here. You know, I thought we could just talk to her and we wanted to go. Or that we could find a way out from here, but this isn't really so. If we go this way, we just get the map. I mean, is this something we haven't taken care of? If we go this way the same way.
First.
We've been to all those places. Are we supposed to speak to somebody when we want to leave? Maybe someone inside?
Let's talk more fight!
I am glad to see you well. The intruder's weapons were poisoned, but Timora smiled upon us. The poison was weak and fatal only to the weakest of victims. Imuin's heart beats much stronger than that. It's worrisome that the palace was so easily penetrated, and to learn that Kalar's reach extends this far beyond the winding water. Our gratitude and prayers go with you. Until we speak again.
I can't help but think maybe Duke Belt? I'm not sure. Is he up here? Yeah.
Accept my apologies. My intent was to keep you and Imowyn safe. Kalar's assassins, indeed any assassins, should never have been able to breach the palace.
We've had this conversation before. Check on Imowyn, and beyond that, I'm not really sure what else there is to be done. This guy's rude, isn't he?
I trust you are here in good faith.
Was he rude? I'm not sure. Just enforcers.
Let's talk more fight!
So I'm not sure what we're supposed to be doing because I'm ready to go. And
let's talk more fight!
We can't go. Corwin, maybe you've talked to her out here. Okay. Okay, we need to talk to her in here. Have you completed your preparation? She asked. Once we start marching north, there'll be no coming back to the city. Yes, I'm ready to begin the march to Dragonspear.
All right. I'll see you on the morrow. Word is your friend Imowen's mostly recovered from the Crusader poison, if you want to speak with her. Just remember, once you go up to your room, I'll leave to begin preparing for the journey. You won't get another chance to head out into the city.
Okay, now we're going back up again. We just talked to her. She must have recovered quite a bit once we went down the stairs.
Yes.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Yeah, my party has to figure out what they're doing. Come on, guys. It's the stairs. I knew they could figure it out.
Sword first!
Hey, hey.
So this is the Slayer of Saravok, the hero of Baldur's Gate. How pleased I am to make your acquaintance.
As I'm sure I will be yours once you tell me how you got in here.
If it is security you desire, it would be prudent to reconsider your sleeping arrangements. I suspect the palace's weaknesses have become all too apparent to you of late.
Indeed.
Strange. There lies within you barely a spark of divine consciousness, yet you bested your brother in blood. How? What is it that drove you to victory where so many others fell in defeat?
I believe it was the teachings of my foster father, Gorion, that saw me through.
Gorion. His death was the first step of your current journey, was it not? I wonder what wisdom did he impart that left such an impression?
He made certain I knew what I needed to know to survive.
Interesting. We will see if that is enough to bear you through the trials ahead.
Okay.
You do not see it yet, but another crossroads in your journey lies before you. One you will reach sooner than you think. The path you choose is of interest to me.
And who the hell are you?
Already I see that path's course. You humble yourself, brushing off your great deeds modestly. I would see you accept the accolades you deserve.
He certainly has a lot to say about what he's interested in, what he wants. Just not who he is.
But we can speak more of this in time when I am certain that you are the one I seek.
Who are you? What do you want?
Suffice it to say that I am a man who has lost much, but would regain some measure of what was taken from me. That is all you need know.
That's actually something I don't need to know.
I am not here to act, not yet. I am here to evaluate. Are you worthy? Is what you carry within enough? Are you strong enough to overcome the challenges you shall soon face?
And why should I care what you think?
Only the passage of time will provide us answers. I'm curious to see how this plays out. I will be watching.
Good for you. I must be alert for the presence of the hooded man. Disturbing implications. I encountered a strange man lurking in my quarters at the Ducal Palace. He did not identify himself, but seemed to know me. His words disturbed me for reasons I cannot quite articulate. Okay. Hey, Emuin.
Oh, you're back. Sorry if I don't seem excited to see you. Poison really takes a toll.
Well, just imagine it's me talking to him when actually I didn't mean for the mints to go up. What was that man in the hood doing here?
You don't know him? He said he was a friend of yours. We've known some pretty strange characters, so I didn't think it was weird to have someone pop in looking for you.
I don't know who he is. He's certainly no friend of mine.
Forget about him. We need to talk about your going to battle the Crusade. I know you think you have to do this, but I am telling you, you don't. Not only do you not have to do it, you shouldn't.
So you think I should just abandon this and go right to Baldur's Gate too?
I'm healing, but you need to heal too. Not just from fighting Saravok. Those are just cuts and scars. But in coming to terms with, you know, what you are. Let someone else take care of the Shining Lady. Please.
The city needs me, though. What would you have me do?
I'd have you tell the city to take a long walk off a short pier. That's what I'd have you do. But you won't, will you? I know that look in your eyes. I'm wasting my breath.
Plus, that'd have to be a pretty big pier. Short, but wide.
Promise me you'll be careful, all right? I don't know what I'd do if... We've just lost too many people, you know? I'm gonna leave now. Take care of yourself.
Where are you going? Come back. I'm resting again. Okay. Is that me falling into bed? Or did something hit me?
Hey!
Imowen?
Are you awake?
Oh, that's Ski. This really should be pronounced Sky. Ski is just... I am now, Ski.
You can't tell Daddy, Duke Silvershield, about this.
I don't even know what this is.
I've joined the Flaming Fist!
No, you haven't.
No, really, I have. Not under my name, of course. Daddy would never allow it. But I'm in it now!
You look a little bit like Lily Black.
Life as a noble is boring and stupid. I want to do something great with my life. And also get out of this dirty old city. And maybe meet some handsome soldiers. So, I'm going north with you.
Wow, that's... something.
I know! All right, go back to sleep. I'll see you in... Oh, I guess you don't really have time to sleep now. I'll see you soon.
Disturb my rest? You lost some major points there. And she acts like we're best buddies. I thought it was Imowen.
Remember, whatever you do, don't tell Daddy about this.
Mm-hmm. How many times am I going to see this screen this episode?
Here is the hero, raring and ready to go. The early bird catches the evil worm. Isn't that right, Boo?
Oh-ho, sounds like...
I got out of bed for this. And if there's one thing I'm loath to do in a bed, it's get out of it.
TMI, Savannah. Min says, oh-ho, sounds like some miniature giant space hamster woke up on the wrong side of the ranger. So we got a quest for Ski's grand plan. I can keep Ski's plan to myself, or I can alert her father, Grand Duke Silvershield. Ski Silvershield came to my room last night. Apparently she's joined the Flaming Fist under an assumed name. Ski seemed to think this is a grand adventure. She has no idea how difficult soldier's life is. So that's the thing she had to tell me. That, and all of a sudden, we seem like better friends than we ever were.
The sooner we reach Dragonspear Castle, yes, the sooner we shall learn whether thy father spawned Kalar, as well as thee and Saravok.
This comfortable bed offers luxury you never found in Candlekeep. Alright, let's go.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Let's talk more fight!
Okay. So where's Corwin? We go to here, I think.
Yes.
I wonder if they're going to have anything new to say. They're all gathered here. Look at that.
Our prayers and hopes go with you. With your help, I'm sure we'll be able to stop the crusade before it grows any stronger.
The Flaming Fist travels with you under the command of Captain Corwin and Corporal Duncan. I'm sorry that Duke Elton could not be present, but the ongoing crisis has called his attention elsewhere. Is there anything else you need before you depart?
What route will we take to Dragonspear Castle? Belt says you'll have to travel by major roads. The contingent is too large to move swiftly over land. You'll cross the winding water at Coastway Crossing, then it's a straight march to Dragonspear. Alright, the winding water.
Coastway. Is there anything else?
Coastway Crossing. Hang on. Nothing.
May the gods look upon you with favor.
Thank you. Belt says, may Timora smile on you, Sapphire. If anyone can end this threat to the city,
you
it is you.
You better get moving, unless there was something else.
I don't even know what kind of, what class Ski is. Yeah, I'm gonna not tell him.
Speak with Captain Corwin by the main doors, and be on your guard. The trip north will likely hold dangers besides the crusade.
Undoubtedly. Yeah, I'm gonna, not tell him whatever lessons Ski has to learn, she can learn on her own. And where's Corwin? Maybe she's outside.
Look at all the people come to wish us good fortune in our travels, Boo!
Rafus, who's that? Rafus says, let us be off. Every moment we delay, Kalar's heresy corrupts fresh hearts. Corwin says, and you'll take care of your grandfather while I'm away? Fog? That's a hell of a name. Says, keep gawking, wide-eyed stooges that you are. Rama says, well, I will, Mama, because she's saying goodbye to her kids.
Let's talk more fight!
I know, Mama, I love you too. Corwin says, I love you very much, Rama, you know that, right? Fog says, what are you looking at? Phil Durkin's sleeves, the lot he is. Mint says, let's talk more fight. I know, Mama, I love you too, Roma says. Rafa says, Kalar will fall. Tis the main god's will. Audemar. Roma. The Argents are a pious and noble line. Kalar has stained their name. I shall see it redeemed, Rafa says. Well, that's Rafus. Fog says, let's go already. Me hammer's ready to pound stomach, and she's not too picky about what? Viconia? Oh, I remember her. We met her very briefly in the main. Let's talk to the kid. The kid wants attention.
I want my mommy.
Your mommy's right next to you. Roma says, Mama, who is that? Is that the hero? Be charming. Captain Corwin, who is this delightful child? Roma says, I'm not a child. I'm 5 years old. I stand corrected.
This is my daughter, Roma.
Roma, this is Sapphire. Roma says, I know you. You killed Saravak. Are you going to kill Kalar, too? I'm hoping it won't come to that.
They'll do what they have to.
Just like you?
Exactly like that.
Have no fear, Roma. I'll make sure nothing happens to your mother. Mama doesn't need you. She can take care of herself. Well.
Oh, I like this little one. She has a fire in her belly.
Finally, something Safana says that I actually agree with and does not nauseate me.
That's right. Now give me a hug, Roma, and go to your grandfather. Mama's gotta get going.
I learned that Captain Corwin is a mother. Journal updated. Captain Corwin is our young daughter, Roma. It can't be easy to leave a child behind knowing you may not return. Rafus says, let us be off. Every moment we delay, Kalar's heresy corrupts fresh hearts. Now who's Fog? That's Fog. Are they all joining us? Rafus? Belagorm? Who's Belagorm?
I have many fine wares.
Greetings, Sapphire. If you need any supplies for the road, I can provision you. For a suitable fee, of course. Surely you jest. You would have me pay for the honor of saving the city yet again? I have the basic supplies for soldiers. You aren't one. Become a fist and you'll get a bedroll. Otherwise, you'll have to show me some gold. What do you have for supplies? What are you looking for? Let me see your scrolls and potions. Here, have a look. Okay, so we get a different... Depending on how we answer, we get a different... selection here. Potions of extra healing. I'll take the lot. Oh, that's right. We really don't have money anymore, do we? How much is... I'm wondering if he has raised dead now. I mean, I know we have some more, but... Let's buy two more.
Such crowds of tiny people. Make way for Minsk and Boo, tiny ones!
An army marches on its stomach.
Well, I don't think you're serving food. Special magic items. A bag of holding. Can't afford. 11,800. Good to know. If I make, well, probably myself in this case, the, because I think I have a decent charisma. Could get it for lower, but we will still not have enough. As with other magical bags, this one appears to be a common cloth sag of about 2 feet by 4 feet size. The bag of holding opens into a non-dimensional space, and its inside is larger than its outside dimensions. Regardless of what is put into this item, the bag always weighs a fixed amount. We could use a bunch of those. Ammo belt. The shoulder belt is ideally suited for holding sling bullets, darts, arrows, or bolts. Alright, so we're gonna be saving up for a bag of holding, but we can't come back here. That's the only problem. Hopefully we can find one somewhere else. Do I have anything to identify? I forgot, no.
I have many fine wares.
Weapons are mostly what I have. Instruments of violence and murder, if that's what you want. They're just, well, other than the arrows, it's like just mundane weapons here. And the bolts, slings, plus one. You know, I should check our bullet inventory. We have plenty. What about arrows? We have a good selection, but not that many of each one. Oh, and I figured Lon's amulet. This is an effect bless. It seems to be a passive ability because there's no charges. Wisdom plus one, I guess, against shapeshifters. And bless. So, we all... I want to get rid of this, because it gives us an extra second level spell. I could do this, but I've never used it. I keep forgetting we have it, and this is good. I think I used this once or twice. The green stony amulet from Minsk helps against charm, confusion, fear, etc., which is good because he's easily affected by that stuff because of his low intelligence. So I think I'll just give it to Safana, is the only one left. And it gives her a plus one to hit and a plus one damage. So that's a good thing. Oh, and the other thing is, forgot to say. Hold on. I don't even see this. The quick loot was off. I turned it on. Viconia says, you have a problem with drow? Look elsewhere, lest I pluck your eyes from your skull. That's a good image there. There's a lot of people packed into this tiny space. Good job. And there's something else. Here. I changed something here. Right, this was off. Only switch to melee after depleting all equipped ammo stacks. This was off, I turned it on. So that's it for that. That's the only changes I made. The auto loot, and that was switched off like that. Alright, so we maybe could use some
you
more...
Want boo?
Oh, he's got plenty of magical arrows he's holding on to. I mean, she can hold some of it. And she also was got arrow plus one, arrows of fire, arrow of biting. He has ice. And he has more fire. Alright, so what else does this guy sell?
Sword first!
An army marches on its stomach!
Armor? Look at that. Buckler of the Fist plus two. Members of the Flaming Fist Mercenary Company that serves Baldur's Gate and surrounding areas often carry these bucklers. A red flame emblazoned on the front of the shining bucklers clearly identifies the bearer's loyalty. Experienced Flaming Fist members often have their shields enchanted. Armor class plus three. Immunity to hold person. Armor class plus three. Actually, there's no one here that uses shields. Tempted to buy one for whoever might join, but for all I know, they might already have one or something better than it. I'll leave it.
I have many fine wares!
So, I looked at everything else here.
An army marches on its stomach.
I'm looking for the quartermaster. I don't know why I asked this. And you found him. Good for you. You want anything else? Special items. Yeah, this is... Now, why do we have a chance...
I have many fine wares.
Why does he have... You have some problem with me, sir? Aye, the council may think the sun shines from your nethers, but I've heard the rumors. Maybe you are the hero, the bards say, or maybe you're in league with Saravak. Time will give an answer to that, I suspect. Till it does, I've orders to supply you, as long as you have coin to pay for it. Okay, let's talk to Raphus.
Hello there. The hero of Baldur's Gate, am I right?
That's what they call me, though I'm not comfortable with the title. Yeah. The expectations of others need not be a burden. My own destiny, to become a paladin of Tyr, as had all the men of my family, was mapped out from birth. As a boy, I fought against it. I did not embrace a life lived in service to others.
It was fear that compelled me. The fear of not rising to the call. And so I took the mantle and faced my fear. And when I did, I embraced it and discovered purpose, courage, and life. I am Rafus Goodtree. It is an honor to meet you. And it will be a greater honor still to fight the Shining Lady at your side.
Will you join my party, then? I could use a sword such as yours. Alas, I have agreed to serve at the pleasure of Corporal Duncan. However, I should be happy to look after any of your companions with goodly hearts. Should you dismiss them from your service and later acquire them, you will find them near me. Best of luck, hero. Okay, I met a paladin in service to the Flaming Fist. Rafus Goodtree is a noble paladin accompanying us on the march north. He will gather any good-hearted companions of mine that I dismiss, so I can find them later. Easily find them later, should I need them. Okay. And then we got Petrescus. Talk to me when you're ready to leave, Sapphire. Two scouts, six in the vanguard, three on either side behind. 8-hour rotation. Now who's Audemars?
I deserve to be leader.
Wait.
What? Let's talk more fight!
What is it?
Audemars. Audemars says Kalar Arjun is a madwoman, a chosen of the gods, or possibly both. Whatever the case, she's clearly dangerous. Take care on your journey. Do I know you? Name's Audemars Corwin. Gauntlet, Flaming Fist, retired. Oh, is that her father? You're traveling north with my daughter, Shale. Shale. Shale Corwin? Is that her name? See to it she returns safely. My granddaughter, Roma, has already lost a father. I'll not see her lose Shale, too. I didn't realize she actually had a first and last name. Farewell, Sapphire. Alright. Let's talk to, Petrescus.
Mission there to be done, no time to stay in chatter.
Well met, my friend. And how's this morning find you? Well, thanks. I'm glad to hear it. There are many depending on you to resolve the Kalar situation as you did with Saravak. I'll do what I can, but I'm just one woman. You are far more than that, as you all know. Do you wear a hood and frequent the palace chambers in the late hours? These questions remind me of another. You are more than a simple adventurer now. You have become a symbol. People cheer your name and look to you for hope. 'Tis a great responsibility, a greater burden than I'd ever want to bear. Be vigilant. I wouldn't want anything to happen to the hero of Baldur's Gate. Alright, and Forg?
Look at this lot. Kayla's gonna take one look at him and die laughing.
How much longer must we wait? Crowds are fickle things. I know too well what can happen when moods turn sour.
Vaconia? Is that you?
What's this now? Ardrow knows the hero of Baldur's Gate?